That's Horsey McHorseface, by the way. This is his grandfather.
One of the most hated modern Ferraris, I think.
Nice car, man!
What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today, well, today is a beautiful summer's evening. It is still quite hot out, and, well, just a lovely evening to drive a Ferrari. And today, that is the Ferrari California.
But first, let me introduce you to the sponsor of today's video, Raid Shadow Legends. Explore millions of champion combinations and master countless tactics as you take on raid bosses, dungeon runs, campaign battles, and PvP arena matches. With hundreds of artifacts to equip and over 500 champions blessed with unique skills, you can build your team, develop your champions, and raid your way. Use our QR code on screen right now or the links in the description to download the game to your mobile phone or computer. Now, the cool thing about Raid is the fact that it has so many ways to enjoy your time within the game. You can play as banner lords who have cool armor and weapon designs based on the knights of medieval Europe. For now, here are a few banner lord champions that I think look cool. And this month, Raid's got a non-stop schedule of summer events and activities. We're talking special fusion events, tournaments against other players, and much more. They're also releasing 5 amazing new champions. Raid's summer plans are just starting to heat up, and there are some giant updates coming very soon. So there's really never been a better way to start playing. If you want to get a huge head start in Raid, all you have to do is click the links in the description or the QR code right here. Scan that code. New players will get an epic hero, Konaru, 200k silver, 1 XP boost, 1 energy refill, and 1 ancient shard, so you can summon an awesome champion as soon as you get in game. Look at this cool champion you'll get for free. You'll find your extra rewards here in your inbox for the next 30 days only. Thanks for watching and enjoy the video.
This car was introduced in 2008 and went all the way to 2014 when it was replaced by the California T with the turbocharged V8. This is the original one, so we still have the naturally aspirated engine, which is awesome. So today I'm going to show you around it, show you all the cool stuff on it, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for a little Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check out Buena Vida Supercar Rental, who were kind enough to let us borrow their car. This is their California, but it is sold now, so you can't rent this anymore, but there are a few other Ferraris available for you to rent and drive. So go check out the website. I'll link that in the description and the top comment. They've got some really cool cars for rent, so go check them out if you're interested. Now, the California, let's start with the start. Let's start at the beginning, because the California is one of the most hated modern Ferraris, I think. People really felt that this was not a real Ferrari when it came out. It got really mixed reviews. Some people really loved it for what it is, a GT car. An introduction into a new segment for Ferrari, a fourth model line that was introduced. The comfortable car that was supposed to attract a new kind of customer to Ferrari, and that was its purpose. There are a few firsts, like it's got the V8 in the front. It is a front mid-engined car, but the V8 is in the front. That's the first time for a Ferrari. Normally the V8s are in the rear, the V12s are up front. It's also the first Ferrari with a foldable hardtop. So not cloth, but a hard top. I'll show you guys in a minute. And it's also the first Ferrari with the 7-speed Geertruck dual clutch transmission. So there were a few things that people really didn't like about this car. And I have to say that I was one of them. Back in the day, I'll be honest, when this car came out, I felt like this wasn't really a Ferrari. But now, driving it, I do get what its purpose is. And I think it's actually a pretty good car. Yeah, I have to admit that I was quite wrong back then. It's got an all aluminium body, an all aluminium chassis. It's got carbon ceramic brakes, a naturally aspirated V8 with 460 horsepower. I mean, the specs are really good actually. It's also the first V8 with direct injection at the front, and also the first Ferrari with multi-link suspension at the rear. So quite a few things were introduced on this car, and I didn't really realize that back in the day. Now,
Let's, I don't know why I'm here already, because I wanted to show you guys the wheels, of course. These are them. They are, well, a classic California wheel. These are, I think, the launch wheels as well, with, as I said, some carbon ceramic brakes behind that. Pretty large discs, actually. And they do squeak a bit, so fair warning. But this is like an old school carbon ceramic brake, which had that problem more than they have now. Designed by Pininfarina, world famous Pininfarina. And at the rear, you can see that this massive thing here, that is where the convertible roof, or the roof, the foldable roof, houses. Let's open that sucker up so I can show you guys. It's actually quite a big boot lid, and there is the mechanism. So you have this little divider here. So when you have the roof closed, this goes up and you have a little bit more storage. When the roof goes down, this has to be down as well. But you can see the mechanism here. It's all quite trick. And you can also see why they had to place these rear lights here, because you can't have them, or brake lights at least, these are the brake lights, you can't have them on a moving part. So you still have to have brake lights when this is gone. That's why the lights are there. And apparently that wasn't really the plan. The plan was to have the brake lights in here like the rest of them did, but that wasn't possible, so that's why they are there. We also have the quad exhaust with the tailpipes one above the other. And apparently there's some really trick stuff going on in here with the heat of the exhaust gases, and it's supposed to create a vacuum inside that little box there, which sucks out air from the wheel well, which generates downforce. So that's quite cool, right? I thought so. Let's check out the engine. There we go. So as you can see, front mid-engined 4.3 liter naturally aspirated V8, 460 horsepower, 485 newton meters of torque. Quite a bit of torque for a naturally aspirated engine, and also quite a bit of horsepower per liter for a naturally aspirated engine. 106 horsepower, that's not bad actually. So it's actually like a 4,296 cc's or something like that, instead of the 4,300 whatever of the F430, because they used a different crank for this car that apparently suited this car better than the 430's character, which is quite cool. And in here, well, in here it is, it's quite a good GT interior, I would say. It's very spacious, and the ride height is a little bit higher. Visibility is really good. Now, we do have some rear seats here, but as you can see, that is just, that is not a lot of space. You don't even have headrests. And in here, you can actually see that deployable roll bar. So if you would sit here, I would really recommend tilting your head forwards, so you don't get that roll bar in your neck when you roll over. I mean, I would be freaking scared of that. That's really crazy. That's Horsey McHorseface, by the way. This is his grandfather. So that's a real thoroughbred. And well, we've got the Manettino here, comfort, sport, and traction control off, three modes. Nice simple steering wheel with a start button and some pedals behind that. And we've got a red rev counter as well. Now, this, however, is terrible. This apparently, well, you can see that, but apparently this is the same system you get in a Chrysler 300C. So it's a Chrysler, it's a Chrysler system, and it looks absolutely horrible. Even back then, when this car came out in 2009, 2008, people were saying, this is not good enough. I mean, and it's not, I'm just turning it off. So we've got that 7-speed DSG gearbox with the paddle shifters. Around 18,000 of these Californias were built. Almost all of them with the 7-speed dual clutch transmission. Apparently there are three with a manual transmission. Now, that would be really cool, actually. There's one in Britain, and I don't know where the other two are, but that is freaking awesome. So I'm going to close that up. Don't worry, we're going to drive with the roof down, but I just want to show you guys. That's how it closes. 14 seconds, I believe. And that is what it looks like with the roof up. So you can see that super sloping line down the side. But I mean, this car was made to be driven with the roof down, of course. So that's what we're going to do. So let's take it for a drive and I'll let you guys hear what this car is all about, because we do have a different exhaust. Completely forgot about that. This is a Tubi exhaust apparently, and it is quite loud. So we're going to hit auto for the manual shifting, and especially down low RPM, you can hear that exhaust. I really believe that this is not stock, because it's actually quite loud. So this car was made to be a GT car, right? A car you can drive every day, a car that you can take to the shops, a car that you can drive from the north of Europe to the south of France, stuff like that. But it's also supposed to be a Ferrari, right? And it is. I mean, of course, it's like the entry-level Ferrari, or it was back then when it came out. And I think that's also why it got a bit of hate, because, well, entry-level cars tend to get a bit more hate because they're like the least coveted Ferrari, right? It's the least coveted Ferrari, so I think that's part of why it got so much hate. Because actually, now we would all be very happy with a naturally aspirated V8. And it still holds its own. I mean, it's not a mega quick car, but it sounds really good. The shifts are really quick. That 7-speed gearbox, oh. And sometimes you get those little crackles on the upshifts. And on the downshifts as well, by the way, but that little rumble, oh, that is just absolutely lovely. Oh man, I mean, what is better than driving a V8 convertible, naturally aspirated, revving to 8,000 RPM. Oh, man. That is just awesome. That was Martijn doing his review of the Ferrari 458. And since we've got a compact program today, we're going to do the draggy measurements, the 100 to 200, in the review as well. So I'm going to put it in auto mode for the best shifts. And then we're going to slow down a bit and floor it. Okay, we're going to do that in manual, that's much better. To 100, it's actually supposed to do 3.9, I think. have a Ferrari California 4, right? .28, there it is. Let's try that in third gear. Some more measurements because it's probably quicker with the roof up. So immediately you can hear that that beautiful V8 is a bit further away, but it still sounds very nice. Okay, so we're going to do another measurement, 100 to 200. Third gear. Here we go. The sun is setting beautifully, and we are driving a really nice car. I have to say that was 1094. Quickest so far. Another one. Doesn't matter. Brakes still work really well, as you could see. I mean, as I said, it's not a mega quick car. 100 to 200 in 10.94. I mean, it's quick, but it's not shockingly fast. But it's a GT car, so it doesn't have to be as on edge and as aggressive as a Ferrari 458, for instance, which feels completely different. That car Martijn is reviewing, I'll let him pass now so you can see. Here he comes. There he is. Nice car, man. He goes. That car feels completely different to this. If you get into that and into this after, this feels like a big boat. So that's what this car is made for, and it is really good at that, I have to say. Last little run before the border. Is over. I hope you enjoyed this video. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You could also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye guys.